Good morning, students. Now today we let's see the rest of the topic of Norma Bezalis. We covered the half of the middle part of the Norma Bezalis, and today we are seeing the rest of the middle part along with the posterior part of the Norma Bezalis. In this rest of the middle part means this area we are seeing the one triangular shaped bone. That bone is name is called the petrous part of temporal bone. So totally four temporal bones are present. Four parts of the temporal bone. One is the squamous part, and second one is the tympanic part. Third one is the petrous part, and fourth one is the mastoid part. So this is the petrous part of the temporal bone. So in this rest of the part, we are seeing the sulcus tube. Inferior surface of the petrous part of temporal bone means this part, and foramina lacerum. This is the foramina lacerum, and tympanic part of the temporal bone. Here it is present, small tympanic part of the temporal bone, and squamous part of the temporal bone. I will show you what is the squamous part of the temporal bone, and squamotympanic fissure. These will be covered in the middle area, the middle part of the Norma Bezalis. Yesterday, the last class, we are seeing in the middle area two nasal apertures, and here is the omer bone, and this is the pterygoid process, lateral pterygoid plate and the medial pterygoid plate. Next, this area we called as a greater wing of the infratemporal surface of the greater wing of the sphenoid bone. In this one, we are seeing four foraminas. Two are the major foraminas. One is called foramina ovale, and second is the foramina spinosum. Let's we talk today. Class is the rest of the middle area. First is the sulcus tubae. Here we can see this is called a petrous part of the temporal bone and the greater wing of the sphenoid bone. In between these two bones, there is one groove is present. That groove name is called the sulcus tubae. In the sulcus tubae, eustachian tube, or we call the auditory tube, it located in this sulcus. That is about the sulcus tube. Next, inferior surface of the petrous part of temporal bone. This is the part, inferior surface. Because superior surface is present in the cranial fossils. This we are seeing in Norma Bezalis. That's why it's the inferior surface of the petrous part of temporal bone. So this bone, the shape is the triangular in shape. See properly, it is a triangular in shape. You can see. It is a triangular shape bone. The apex, this part is the apex. Apex near to the sphenoid bone, or between the greater wing of the sphenoid bone and body of the sphenoid bone, the apex. And in this inferior part of the greater petrous part of temporal bone, we are seeing the one canal. That canal name is called the carotid canal. In this carotid canal, three structures are passes. One is the internal carotid artery and sympathetic chain and venous plexus. These three structures are passing through the carotid canal. This carotid canal finally open into the foramina lacerum. The direction is toward the anterior and the medial side. Toward the anterior and medial side. So this is about the inferior surface of the petrous part of temporal bone. Next, we are seeing the foramina lacerum. This is the foramina. Foramina lacerum. It present between the greater wing of the sphenoid and apex of the petrous part of temporal bone. So here, in this foramina lacerum, why we call it the foramina lacerum? Because lacerum means the irregular. The foramina is an irregular in shape. In this foramina, two canals are open. One is the carotid canal, and toward the anterior side, one more canal is open. That is called a pterygoid canal. These two canals are open into the foramina lacerum. And some structures are passes here. Which are the structures is in the carotid canal? Internal carotid artery and the sympathetic chain and venous plexus. These are the crosses here. These all are the cross in the foramina lacerum. Foramina lacerum, two structures are passes directly. Those are called as a ascending pharyngeal artery and emissary vein. And lastly, one nerve also forms here. The formation of one nerve, that nerve name is called the median nerve. So median nerve is formed by the union of two nerves, greater petrosal nerve and the deep petrosal nerve. Greater petrosal, deep petrosal, both are the union in the foramina lacerum forms the median nerve. This is about the, what is that one? Foramina lacerum. Now next, tympanic part of the temporal bone. So this is the squamous part, mastoid part and tympanic part, and this is called the petrous part. Now our topic is the tympanic part of temporal bone. The bony plate, it is a triangular shape bony plate. It is present between the squamous part, this is squamous part, and along with the petrous part, between the squamous and the petrous part. Anteriorly, this is towards the anterior side. Anteriorly here, one gland is related, that gland name is called as a parotid gland. This is about the tympanic part of the temporal bone. Now next is the squamous part of the temporal bone. See here, this is squamous part. Little bit, small amount of this squamous part is present in the norma basalis. One is called as a ear, the fossa, this fossa name is called as a mandibular fossa. Head of the mandible is attached here, forms the temporomandibular joint. And next, we have the anterior tubercle. This is called a tubercle. Anterior tubercle. And lastly, from the roof of infratemporal fossa. This is the infratemporal fossa. It forms the roof here. So this is about the squamous part of the temporal bone. Last is the squamotympanic fissure. In this squamotympanic fissure, again the squamotympanic fissure divided into the squamotympanic and petrotympanic fissure. See, this is the tympanic part of temporal bone, and this is the squamous part of the temporal bone. In between fissure is there. That fissure name is called as squamotympanic fissure. Again, this squamotympanic fissure is divided into the two parts, which is the between the squamous part and the tympanic part, squamotympanic. And here, little bit is present here between the tympanic part and the petrous part. That name is called as a petrotympanic fissure. This is a squamotympanic fissure. And here is the petrotympanic fissure. So in this petrotympanic fissure, few structures are passes. Those structures are the caudal tympanic nerve and anterior tympanic artery and the ligament of malleolus. These all structures are passing through the petrotympanic fissure. So this is about the middle part of the norma basalis. Now we can see the practically middle part of the norma basalis. Already we have seen these are the posterior nasal apertures, and this is called the humor bone, posterior border of the humor, and pterygoid process, medial pterygoid plate and the lateral pterygoid plate. And come to the here, this is called the infratemporal surface of the greater wing of the sphenoid. In this one, foramina ovale and foramina spinosum, we are seeing these parts. Now today class is the sulcus tubae. The first one is called the sulcus tubae.
This is called the greater wing of the sphenoid and the petrous part of the temporal bone. In between, there is a groove is present, this groove and this groove. The groove name is called as a sulcus tubae. In the sulcus tubae, cartilaginous part of the eustachian tube, neither we call as a auditory tube, neither we call as a pharyngeal tympanic tube is present in this place, that is called as a sulcus tubae. The next is that this area, see this triangular area, only this triangular area. The triangular area name is called as a inferior surface of the petrous part of temporal bone. So in this one, it is located behind the greater wing of the sphenoid bone. Where? And in this one, one canal is present. This is the canal. The canal name is called the carotid canal. This carotid canal, few structures are passes. Those structures are the, one is the internal carotid artery, sympathetic joint, and the venous plexus. The carotid canal, means this canal, it is forward anteriorly toward the medial side, opening into the foramina lacerum. This is the name is called a foramina lacerum. The next comes to the foramina lacerum. What is the mean of foramina lacerum? Foramina lacerum means is the irregular in shape. The shape is the irregular. So carotid canal, so this canal is opening into the foramina lacerum, and from here, in this part, here see, small opening is there, you can see here very clearly. This is called as a pterygoid canal. So two canals, one is a carotid canal and second one is a pterygoid canal. The both canals are open into the foramina lacerum. So few structures are directly passing from here. In the interior of this skull, this is called as a foramina lacerum. Okay, from here to few structures, those two structures are passes. One is the ascending pharyngeal artery and second one is called as a emissary vein. So these are passing through the foramina lacerum. And internal carotid artery and sympathetic joint and venous plexus, those are from the carotid canal to reach to the here in this place, but it not passing from in this one, it crosses transversely to the foramina lacerum. Then next is the one nerve is formed here. The nerve name is called the median nerve. It is formed by the greater petrosal and the deep petrosal nerves. So this is about this triangular shaped bone, petrous part of temporal bone. Here is the one carotid canal is opens and the one foramina lacerum is present. Next come to about the tympanic part of the temporal bone. See here, it is a triangular shaped bony plate. It is present behind the squamous part and the from the side of the petrous part. So in this one, it is anteriorly here, anterior side. So this is the anterior side. It is anterior side. Here is one gland is related. The gland name is called the parotid gland. Next is called the squamous part. In the norma basalis medial area, squamous part, this area, small area is the squamous part of the temporal bone. Here, three structures are present here. One is called a mandibular fossa and second one is called anterior tubercle. And third one it forms a roof of the infratemporal surface. This is the infratemporal surface. Here it forms the roof of the infratemporal surface. Lastly, we have in the squamous part and the tympanic part. In between, the fissure is there. See, this fissure name is called as a squamotympanic fissure. Again, this fissure is divided into the medial side and the lateral side. Lateral side we called as a squamotympanic fissure, but medial side we called as a petrotympanic fissure. In this fissure, few structures are passes. Those are the caudotympanic nerve, anterior tympanic artery, and the ligamentum of malleolus. These three structures are passing through the petrotympanic fissure. This is about the middle part of the norma basalis.
Now next is the posterior part of the norma basalis. Here, already explained what imaginary line is passes, which is the part behind the imaginary line that we call the posterior part of the norma basalis. Again, this posterior part of the norma basalis divided into the two areas. One is the median area and second one is the lateral area. The median area means this is the median. Median area and rest of the part is the lateral area. So first we are seeing the median area. In the median area, the largest foramina is present. That foramina name is called as foramina magnum. This foramina magnum is the shape of the foramina magnum, oval shape, and this foramina magnum is connecting the cranial cavity with the vertebral column. Clear? And these margins of the foramina magnum, see here, this is an anterior margin, and here this area is called the posterior margin, and either side the two margins. Why I am explaining this here, a few membranes are attached here. Those membranes extending from the first vertebra, that vertebra name is called as atlas, second is called as axis. Here this is the first vertebra. In the first vertebra, this is toward the anterior side, anterior arch, and this one is the posterior arch. Clear? So one membrane extending from the anterior arch to the foramina magnum, that membrane name is called as atlanto-occipital membrane. Atlas to the occipital, atlanto-occipital, anterior atlanto-occipital membrane. Same way in the posterior side, see here is the posterior here. From in this to in this margin, one more membrane is extended, that membrane name is called as posterior atlanto-occipital membrane. And either side means here and in this place, one more membrane is attached. That membrane actually we call it is a not membrane, we call it as a ligament. That ligament is attached from the second vertebra. This is called an axis. From the second vertebra from here to here is a one ligament added, that is called alar ligaments. This is the posterior margin of the foramina magnum and posterior arch of the atlas. So from here to here is a membrane is attached, that is called a posterior atlanto-occipital membrane. Same way in the anterior side is the anterior atlanto-occipital membrane. And either side, second vertebra, from either side to here in either side, two ligaments are attached. Those ligaments name is called as a alar ligaments. Now again I am showing the diagrammatically. In the anterior margin, here the ligament is attached. That ligament name is called as a anterior atlanto-occipital ligament. Same in the posterior side as well, posterior atlanto-occipital membrane. Either side here, ligament is attached. That ligament name is called as a alar ligament. This ligament is extending from the second vertebra, dens of the axis vertebra. Now these foramina magnum, we are divided into the two parts, anterior part and the posterior part. So for example, one imaginary line passes here. Now we divide the anterior and the posterior. In the anterior part, three structures are passes. Those structures are the first one is called as the alar ligament, and second one is called as the cruciate ligament, and third one is the membrana tectoria. these structures are passing through the anterior part of the foramina magnum. Again and repeat it, three structures are passes. One is the first one is called as the apical ligament, and second one is the cruciate ligament, and third one is the membrana tectoria. Why I am repeating here, in the examination point of view, in the viva point of view, the most question is asking the examiners, the important question is what are the structures are passing through the foramina magnum, anterior part. Now come to the posterior part. In the posterior part, totally seven structures are passes. The first one, the yellow color one, that is called as the lower part of the medulla oblongata, and this brain is covered by the meninges to the finish. And third one, you can see the here the one artery is there, that is called the anterior spinal artery. And fourth one here, posterior spinal arteries. And fifth one is a nerve here, you can see now yellow color, that is called the accessory nerve, spinal root of the accessory nerve. And sixth one is the, again artery is there, this artery is called a vertebral artery. And seventh one is the, this vertebral artery surrounded by the plexus. The plexus, those are called a sympathetic plexus, this sympathetic plexus is surrounding the vertebral artery. So these seven structures are passing through the posterior part of the foramina magnum. Now next is the, come to your, in the median area. Here we know that point, this is called as the external occipital protuberance. See here. The next, second one is called as the external occipital crest, and third one is called as external occipital protuberance. We see in the non-obesalis, here one bony prominence is present, that we call as the external occipital protuberance. Already we have studied the external occipital protuberance in the norma occipitalis. There we have one muscle is attached, that muscle is called as the, above is called as the trapezius, and below is called as the ligamentum nuchae. In this place is the trapezius, and below is called as the ligamentum nuchae. And external occipital crust, from the foramina magnum to the external occipital protuberance, one bony ridge is connected. That bony ridge name is called as a external occipital crust. See here, this is external occipital protuberance and foramina magnum, external occipital crust. So in this crust, only one ligamentum nuchae is attached in the upper part, not in the lower part. So this is about the median area of the posterior part of the norma basalis. Now come to the lateral area. This is the lateral area, and here also lateral. In the lateral area, firstly we are seeing here two bony convex are present, those are called as a occipital condyles. These occipital condyles present in the anterior off of the foramina, means lateral side to the anterior off of the foramina magnum. So these are the convex in nature. See, these are the convex in nature, and these are the articulate with the concave part of the atlas. Form, see here is a joint. That joint name is called the atlanto-occipital joint. And next is the, behind this one, behind the occipital condyles, there is the one fossa is present. So this is the fossa. The fossa name is called as a condylar fossa. Thus condylar fossa leads to form say one canal. That canal name is called as a condylar canal. Behind the occipital condyles, there is a one fossa is present. That fossa name is called as a condylar fossa. That condylar fossa leads to the, forms a one canal. That canal is called as a condylar canal. See, this is a condylar canal. So what are structures are passing in this condylar canal? Emissary vein. That vein is arises from the sigmoid sinus. One more is present.
that is the
here anterolateral side. Anterolaterally to the occipital condyles, one more small canal is present. That canal name is called hypoglossal canal. In this hypoglossal canal, hypoglossal nerve and along with the middle meningeal branch of the ascending pharyngeal artery, and next we have the emissary vein. These three structures are passing through this hypoglossal canal. Not last. In this part, again we are seeing the middle part means foramina magna, extraoccipital crest and extraoccipital protuberance, and this is called as the squamous part of the occipital bone. In this squamous part of the occipital bone, two bony curly ridges extending from the external occipital protuberance, that is called as a superior nuchal line. Again, this nuchal line divided into the medial one-third, lateral two-third. In this medial one-third, trapezius muscle get attached, lateral one-third part, sternocleidomastoid and the splenius capitis. These two muscles get inserted into the lateral one-third part. Next, from the external occipital crest to one bony ridges extending toward the lateral side. This bony ridges name is called as a inferior nuchal lines. So this inferior nuchal lines, they are bony ridges only. Now one vertical line, so these are the vertical lines, divided the this part of the squamous part of the occipital bone into the four parts: upper medial, upper lateral, lower medial, lower. Sir, why I am writing the opposite? See here, come to in this place. External occipital protuberance, external occipital crest, superior nuchal line, inferior nuchal line. One vertical line is extending here. So this is upper medial, upper lateral, lower medial, lower lateral. So in this upper medial, one muscle get attached. Thus muscle name is called as a semispinalis capitis. And here one more muscle get attached, that is called as a oblique superiors. And below here, rectus capitis posterior minor, rectus capitis posterior major is attached in these four areas, that is called a squamous part of the occipital bone. And the posterior part, the next we are seeing the jugular foramina, and the laterally there jugular foramina. Inferior surface of the jugular process of occipital bone, this is occipital bone, jugular process of the occipital bone. And silent process, here is the one bony projection is present. Already we are studying in the normal lateralis talent process. And mastoid process is present here in the mastoid process of the temporal bone. And last we have the stylomastoid foramina. Stylomastoid foramina, styloid and the mastoid. Here is the foramina is present, stylomastoid foramina. First we are seeing about the jugular foramina. Jugular foramina, this is jugular foramina. It is present behind the petrous part of the temporal bone and anteriorly to the occipital bone. There is a one foramina is present, introcious foramina. This introcious foramina divided into the three parts: anterior part, middle part and the posterior part. In this middle part, three nerves are passes, 9th, 10th and 11th cranial nerves are passing through the middle part of the jugular foramina. In the anterior part, inferior petrosal sinus along with one artery is passing, that is called ascending pharyngeal artery. Same in the posterior part, one sinus is passes, that is sigmoid sinus, along with one artery, that is called the occipital artery. So these three these foramina divided into the three parts: anterior, middle and the posterior part. Now let's we talk about the anteriorly to this foramina. In this place we are having the fossa is present. That fossa name is called the jugular fossa. In this jugular fossa, towards the lateral side, you see towards the lateral side, here small minute canal is present. That canal name, minute canal is situated, that canal name is called a mastoid canaliculus. And towards the medial side, here one notch is present, like this notch. The notch name is called the glassopharyngeal notch. Glassopharyngeal notch. And this glassopharyngeal notch in the anterior side, at the apex of the glassopharyngeal notch, we have in the one more opening, small opening in the apex. That opening name is called the cochlear canaliculus. And lastly, we have this small one more canaliculus, minute canal is present, that is called tympanic canaliculus. Petrous part of the temporal bone. Where is the petrous part of the temporal junction of this jugular fossa? Small one more canal, minute canal. That canal name is called as a tympanic part of the, tympanic canaliculus. So this is about the jugular fossa. I will show you practically all these things. Now next come to about the inferior surface of the, so this is the inferior surface of the jugular process of the occipital lobe, which is the part near to the jugular process, which is the part near to the jugular foramen or jugular process. That part name of the occipital bone name is called the jugular process of the occipital bone. In this one muscle will attach here, that is called the rectus capitis lateralis. One bony projection is present, that bony projection name is called the styloid process. See, this is the styloid process. Again, the styloid process having the four surfaces and one apex, anterior surface and the posterior surface, lateral surface, medial surface, apex. From the anterior to one muscle that going towards the tongue side, styloclocius. From medial side to the going toward the pharynx, stylopharynx. Posteriorly to the hyoid bone, stylohyoid. And laterally to the one ligament attached to the mandible, stylomandibular ligament. From the apex to the again hyoid bone, stylohyoid ligament. So these in the question in the examination ask like this, styloid apparatus. Styloid apparatus means styloid is a bony projection, it having the four surfaces and the one apex, anterior surface from here to anterior surface to the one muscle attached, that is the styloglossus, medial to the stylopharynges, posteriorly stylohyoid, laterally from here to the stylomandibular ligament, and apex to the hyoid bone, stylohyoid ligament. So this is about the styloid process. The next we have the mastoid process. See, we know this is a bony projection, is the mastoid part of the temporal bone. Toward the medial side, one notch is present. That notch name is called a digastric notch. Here, posterior belly of the digastric muscle get attached. And still more medially, one more groove is present. Here, a chalk is there. That groove is called as a occipital groove. Here, the occipital artery is present. And between the styloid process and the mastoid process, there is a one foramen is present. This is a foramen. The foramen will be called stylomastoid foramina. In this stylomastoid foramina, facial nerve and the stylomastoid arteries passes. This is about the norma basalis. So read carefully, see video once or twice or thrice, but learn perfectly. Because in the examination, in the viva point of view, we ask each and everything very clearly.
Practically, norma basalis posterior part divided into the medial area and the lateral area. For our convenience purpose, medial area we are seeing the one foramina. That foramen name is called foramina magnum. That foramen magnum anterior margin from here to the occipital. Atlas, one membrane attached, that is called the anterior atlanto-occipital membrane. from here to the posterior atlantic occipital membrane, from the second vertebra to either side. In this place is the ligament is attached. That ligament name is called the ulnar ligament. So this completely foramina divided into the anterior part and the posterior part. In this anterior part, three structures are passes. That structures are the apical ligament, cruciform ligament, membrana tectoria. In the posterior part, completely seven structures are passes. One is the medulla oblongata, second one is the meninges, third one is the anterior spinal artery, fourth one is the posterior spinal arteries, fifth one is the accessory nerve, sixth is the vertebral artery, and seventh is the sympathetic plexus around the vertebral artery. So these structures are passing through the anterior and the posteriorly, and this is the crest, and here is the one elevation is there. This elevation name is called external occipital protuberance. From here to here is the bony curved ridge, bony ridge is there. This is called external occipital crest. From this external occipital protuberance to superior nuchal lines, bony curved ridges, and from the crest to the inferior nuchal lines. Now you can see one vertical line here and here divided this area into the upper medial, upper lateral, lower medial, lower lateral. From the external occipital protuberance to the one more highest point, one more nuchal line is present. That is called a highest nuchal line. One student is asked, what is the difference between the highest, superior and inferior nuchal line? See, beta, here it is very clear. External occipital protuberance, this one. So this is the highest nuchal line, and this one is the superior nuchal line, and this is the inferior nuchal line. Three nuchal lines are very clear in this one. These are the bony curved ridges. Some muscles get attached here and some muscles are inserted here. Clear? Now come to about the lateral area. This is called as a occipital condyles. The occipital condyles present in the anterior part of the anterior one-third part of the foramina magnum. These occipital condyles is attached with the atlas, forms the atlanto-occipital joint. And behind this one, there is one fossa is present. This fossa name is called the condylar fossa. The condylar fossa is containing the one foramina. This is a condylar foramina. In this foramina is called the ascending pharyngeal arteries passes and the emissary vein are passes here. Same in the lateral side, anterior laterally to the condyles, see here. This canal name is called a hypoglossal canal. The hypoglossal canal, hypoglossal nerve is passes, and along with the hypoglossal nerve is passes, meningeal branch of the ascending pharyngeal artery and the emissary vein is passes through this one. And next is the jugular foramina. See better, this is the jugular foramina. This jugular foramina again divided into the three parts, anterior, middle and the posterior. In the anterior part, inferior petrosal sinus and along with the ascending pharyngeal arteries passes. In the middle part, 9th, 10th, 11th cranial arteries passes, and posterior part, sigmoid sinus along with the occipital arteries passes through the jugular foramina. Anteriorly to the jugular foramina, see clearly. This is the jugular foramina, and this area is called the fossa, jugular fossa. In this jugular fossa, toward the lateral side, the small minute canal is present. That canal name is called a mastoid canaliculus. And toward the medial side, here is a notch is there. The notch name is called a glossopharyngeal notch. In this glossopharyngeal notch, apex of the glossopharyngeal notch, one more canaliculus is present, that is cochlear canaliculus. And anteriorly to the jugular fossa, in this place, one more small minute canal is present. here small minute canal is present. That canal leads in the minute canal name is called as a
tympanic canaliculus.
Lastly, this area is called as a jugular process of the occipital bone. Here one muscle get attached, that is called a rectus capitis lateralis, and we know this is called a mastoid stylet process, and this is a mastoid process. In the mastoid process, medial side is there, one notch is there, that is called a digastric notch. Posteriorly of the digastric attach, still more laterally here is the one more groove is there. So still more medially one more groove, that groove is called the occipital groove. Here is the occipital artery is related. So stylet process and the occipital mastoid process, in between small foramina. See, this foramina name is called the stylomastoid foramina. In this stylomastoid foramina, facial nerve and the stylomastoid arteries passes. Thank you so much. If you have any doubt, ask me on my personal number.